girl running toward me from the distance, waving her arms in the air like she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. That girl is Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children. You know the kind of friend you've never seen yourself making today, but it just kind of works out because we've known each other for so long. Used to walk together to school on days like this, but starting around high school, she would oversleep more and more frequently, and I would get tired of waiting up. I don't blame you. But if she's going to chase after me like this, I almost feel better off running away. However, I just sigh and idle in front of the crosswalk and let Sayori catch up to me. Oh, she's kind of cute. I like her little red bow. Ah ha ha! I overslept again. But I caught you this time. Maybe, but only because I decided to stop and wait for you. You say that like you were thinking of ignoring me. That's mean, Bun. Oh yeah, I named myself Bun in this game. Well, if people stare at you for acting weird, then I don't want them to think we're a couple or something. What? Fine, fine. But you did wait for me after all. I guess you don't have it in you to be mean, even if you want to. Whatever you say, Sayori. Cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with other students making their daily commute. By the way, Bun, have you decided on a club yet to join? A club? A club, I told you. I told you already. I'm not really interested in joining any clubs. I haven't even been looking either. You told me you wanted to join this club this year, did I? I'm sure it's possible that I did, but in one of many of our conversations where I dismissively go along with whatever she's going to run about, Sayori likes to worry a little too much about me when I'm perfectly content on just average while spending my free time on you. Alright. Uh-huh. I was talking about how I'm worried that you won't learn socialize or have any skills before college. Your happiness is really important to me, you know. Aw. And I know you're happy now, but I die at the thought of you becoming neat. Becoming a neat in a few years because you're not used to the real world. You trust me, right? Don't make me keep worrying about you. All right, whatever. I'll look at a few clubs if it makes you happy. No promises, though. Will you at least promise me you'll try a little? Yeah, I guess I'll promise you that. Yay! Why do I let myself get lectured by such a carefree girl? More than that, I'm surprised I even let myself relent to her. I guess I'm seeing her worry so much about me makes me want to ease the mind a little bit. Even if she does exaggerate everything inside her head. Oh, nice little classroom. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before you know it. After I pack up my things and stare blankly at a wall, I'm looking for an ounce of motivation. Sayori wants me to check out some clubs. I guess I have no choice but to start with anime club. Hello! Must have come into the classroom while I was spacing out. I look around and realize that I'm not the only one left in the classroom. I thought I'd catch you coming out of the classroom, but I saw you just sitting there spacing out, so I can't. Honestly, you're even worse than me sometimes. I'm impressed! You don't need to wait up for me, if it's going to make you late to your own club. Well, I thought you might need some encouragement, so I thought, you know. Know what? Well, that you could go to my club. Sayori. There is no way I'm going to your club. Mimi. Sayori is a vice president of the literature club. I would not have expected that coming from her. Not that I was ever aware that she had any interest in literature. There you go. In fact, I'm 99% sure she only did it because she thought it would be fun to help start a new club. Since she was the first one to show interest after the one who proposed the club, she inherited the title of vice president. That said, my interest in literature club is guaranteed to be even less. Actually, I'm pretty interested in it. Yeah, I'm going to the anime club. Come on, please. Oh, look at those puppy dog eyes. How can you see? Why do you care so much anyway? Well, I kind of told the club yesterday I'd bring a new member. And Natsuki made cupcakes and everything. Don't make promises you can't keep. I can't tell if Sorori is really that much of an airhead or if she's just cutting on as to playing all of this out. I let out a long sigh. Fine, I'll stop by for a cupcake, okay? Yes, let's go. And thus today marks the day I sold my soul for a cupcake. I dejectedly follow Sayori across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, but generally use for the third year classes. Sayori, full of energy, swings open the classroom door. Everyone, the new member is here. I told you, don't call me a new member. Hey, I glanced around the room. Welcome to Literature Club. It's a pleasure to meet you. I love her purple hair. Ori always says nice things about you. Seriously, you brought a boy? Oh wait, I'm a boy in this game? I didn't know that. Brought a boy? Way to kill the atmosphere. Aw, Bun, what a nice surprise. Aw, these people love me. Welcome to the club. All words escape me in this situation. Well, yeah, no shit. fingers are drawn with the ice pick. Little pieces of chocolate were used to make the ears. So cute. I had no idea you were so good at baking, Natsuki. Well, you know. Just hurry and take one. Aurori grabs one first, then Monica. I follow. It's delicious. Managed to get icing on her face. I turn the cupcake around on my fingers, looking for the best angle to see. That's actually what I do in real life. I usually like spin around my hands just to make sure I'm getting the right snippet. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. Dragged here by sorority. Well, I haven't joined any clubs yet, and sorority seemed like really happy, so it's okay, don't be embarrassed. We'll make sure you feel right at home, okay? As president of the literature club, it is my duty to make the club fun and exciting for everybody. Monica, I'm surprised. How come you decided to start your own club? You'd probably be a board of any of the major clubs. Were you a leader of the debate club last year? Why does it keep doing that? Night. Weren't you a leader of the debate club last year? Aha! Well, you know. To be honest, I can't stand all the politics around the major clubs. It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicity and how to prepare the events. It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicity of how to prepare for events. I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy and make something special out of it. Well, I agree with that. I kind of get that. And if it encourages others to get into literature, then I'm fulfilling that dream. Monica really is a great leader. Curry also nods in agreement. Then I'm surprised that there aren't more people in the club yet. It must be hard to start a new club. You could put it that way. Not many people are interested in putting all the effort into starting something new, brand new. Especially when it's something that doesn't grab your attention like literature. You have to work hard to convince people that you're both fun and worthwhile. But it makes school events like the festival that much more important. I'm confident that we will really grow this club before we graduate. Right, everyone? Yeah. Such different girls are interested in the same goal. level of enthusiasm about it.
Right.